Hey everybody, it's Sherry from Asian Boss. There have been a number of blackface incidents popping up all over Asia. And recently, it happened again on a popular Chinese TV show, which apparently watched by over 800 million Chinese people. So why does something like this keep happening? Are we missing something? To get some real insight, let's hit the street of Shanghai to see what ordinary Chinese people have to say about this incident.
老师，刚刚是个在哪里播出的节目呀？
中央电视台播出的春晚嘛。春晚在中国是很大的一个节目吗？对的，是最大的节目了，等于是。
既然美国人看，那就是 Super Bowl。
基本上大部分的老百姓，可能80%-85%的可能都会去看这个节目。那你能跟我描述一下刚刚你看到一些场面是什么吗？哦，这个讲的是就是中非的一个，可能一个铁路项目还是什么，然后可能其中的一小段。
中国人和非洲人的一个友谊吧。然后呢，就是非洲的有人又，体态非常丰满，然后穿着的非常，就是颜色非常各异，然后又跟我们就是新年非常有那个联系。刚刚看了那个视频当中，其实端的那个水果出来的那个女士，你知道是哪里人吗？
好像是看的时候是非洲的。
其实刚刚那个端水果出来的那位女士其实是中国人。
他其实把这个亚洲人呢涂成了非洲人，把脸涂成了黑色，然后还做了一个假的大的屁股。那你知道这样子这个事实之后，你是怎么想的？
哎，化妆师可以涨工资了。<笑>诧异的，因为我想我们应该可以找到很合适的非洲人来演吧。
他是。
经费不够嘛？难道没有办法请到一个就是非洲的朋友吗？
首先第一个是很滑稽，第二个是觉得中非文化的一种融合吧。
大概反应我觉得应该是一种搞笑吧，应该这个也没有非说要歧视有色人种或者什么。
我觉得没什么呀，就是这个在模仿。 非洲人的一个形体特征吧，体型比较大，然后屁股比较翘，胸比较大。很多非洲人在中国看到都比较苗条，但也有，就是说他们屁股比较翘，但是没有这么翘，就他这个有点过了，就可能达到一个喜剧效果。
那你觉得这个属于是种族歧视吗？
我觉得不是，可能他就是中国人，传统概念里面对非洲人的印象。对某一个国家或者说一个文化的一个固定的观念吧，就像可能国外的人会认为我们中国人可能就是矮矮小小、黄皮肤的那种。那你们，我想告诉你们，是其实很多外国的人在看了这个视频了之后，他们就觉得有点种族歧视。
对对，
你能理解他们这样的想法吗？没什么呀，那中国人胖的也有的呀。其实我觉得看了孩子有可爱可亲。
然后我们其实对外国他们在就是描述我们中国文化的时候，也会有一些不到位的地方。本身的话也是大家在这种就是不断的交流当中去互通有无，然后去增进的。然后如果说真的给外国友人带来这样子就是心理上有些不适的话，可能对于我们以后做节目的时候也会有所改进。
如果是在国外的话，很多外国人，哎，他把自己白人，他把自己人涂成黄色，然后弄个小眼睛，然后去逗乐大家。你如果看到这个东西，你会开心吗？
也没什么不开心，
就是中国人，中国人就是这个样子，黄皮肤呀，又怎么了？
要看他用在什么场合。如果有一些场合他是，就是故意有这种影射的话，也可能会生气。但是如果是出于一些，就是影别人一笑的这种场合，我觉得还可以，是可以接受。
那我会不高兴，
对吧？
我认为他做的有失偏颇。
但
哦，就这个没想到，可能你这样讲到以后就觉得哦，可能是有点这样的问题。这样被你提醒以后，我觉得可能不大好吧。但是我觉得从我中国人的角度说，我是可能说这个的问题是没想到，就别的人的想法。
你周围，你们周围有什么黑人朋友或者黑人同学啊这种之类的吗？
我们上大学的时候，感觉对他们的印象就是很香很香，整层就是上课的时候可能会觉得，只要他们有在教室，整层楼都是香的。
打篮球的时候可能会见到有些黑人朋友，对，很友好。其实黑人朋友总体来说，因为我住的小区里面也有黑人朋友，整体来说是比较友好的，对。
那他们的形象和春晚出现的那些形象一样吗？
不一样，不一样。生活中真的其实很少见那样的。
对的。
虽然小区里有黑人，然后他那个夸张一些。
你是哪里人？
我是河北人。
你是河北人，那你接触到了一些曾经接触到一些黑人是什么样子的形象呢？亲身经历，
比较负面的一些形象。可以说吗？
可以说，可以说，没关系。
就是比较爱占小便宜。
负面的话呢，就比较可能是贫穷。
那你觉得很多时候中国人得到了这些负面的这种印象是从何而来的呢？
是因为一种个别的案例会影响到整个国内的，会影响它的影响。
一方面是可能是经济水平决定的，再一个的话可能跟就是我们从小到大接触到的这些媒体的宣传也有一定的关系。可能如果主流的就是官方宣传上都是介绍到他们一些就是被歧视的一方或者是不平等的东西，我们大多接受到的这些会影响我们的判断。
就是主要通过美剧啊，美国的电影啊，或者他们的描述关于美国的就是这个黑人的那些种族歧视的问题。
那对于中国的一些媒体上有没有一些类似的一些影响呢？
我觉得比较少，可能都是描述别人是怎么种族歧视别人。
对，基本上黑人角色设定会把他们设定成一些小偷啊，会设定一些这个一些罪犯，生活在底层的一些就说是垃圾之类的这种。
你觉得在未来有没有可能啊，我们中国对于一些非洲人的一些负面的一些形象啊，固有形象会更多的消失呢？
那是肯定的，因为没有不了解而产生的问题都会随着交流而解决。
这样的耗时我觉得差不多还得需要三五十年或者是上百年的时间啊，因为这种民族之间的融合还是非常慢的啊，因为从历史上来讲，你说那中国融合了这么多民族，现在才形成一种这种共荣的这种局面，我觉得应该不会说对于黑人有多么大的歧视。整个中国我觉得还是比较有信心。
关键就是说要有这个机会组织一个桥梁，就是当你了解对方越多的时候，那你的心态就会发生改变，对他的认识才更全面。就是因为我们年轻一代就接触新事物，接受新事物的能力会比较强，所以对于这种新鲜的这些外来的文化还是以一种比较客观的眼光在对待。
How long have you been living in China and what motivated you to come here?
So I've been in China, I think around 4.5 years or a little more than that. And I was motivated to come here because I actually studied Chinese in university.
What do you make of the recent incident of blackface on the CCTV Lunar New Year's show?
So I was actually watching that show. At first, when I first saw it, I thought it was an African woman who had a fake butt and stuff, which I thought was weird, but I was like, well, it's China.And which is what, that's a lot of people's responses when they see stuff like this, oh, it's China. And then when I kind of looked at it, I was like, wait, but there's so many Africans in China who speak Chinese. Like, I didn't understand why. It's like, I almost want like someone to explain why it happened. Like, even if they couldn't find an elderly African woman who spoke Chinese, they could have made up a black person to look old. Like, they had so many options.This is from a black American perspective, it's not from African perspective. I don't know what Africans think about that skit. They might be angry, they might not, because the thing is, blackface is historically in the US has negative origins because basically white people would paint their face black. It was very obvious that they were in blackface. They wouldn't try to make themselves actually look like an African American. And they would do stereotypical things, kind of degrading. It was just a way to dehumanize black people, make them more like a character, a cartoon, as opposed to a human being.
Have you encountered like examples of like racism or so on in China or prejudices?
I like to call it colorism in terms of what I've experienced personally myself, which is essentially Chinese people giving me compliments and saying, oh, you're black, but you're not dark. Or they'll make fun of somebody else and go, oh, but he's so dark. And then I'll say, well, what's wrong with that? And I feel part of it is lack of exposure to different types of black people.
What about any of your friends, for example?
They'll see much more racism than I do, where sometimes I think it doesn't exist, and then sometimes I do see where they might be where it might be true. For example, sitting on a subway, some people have said that people won't sit next to them, or they'll like get up, like move away from them. One friend told me that when she was working at Disney, someone called her the Chinese word for the N-word. And so, yeah, it's definitely going to be different for different people. In general, I haven't had too much of a problem. The issue is when you can understand Chinese, I think it makes it a little different. Because, for example, I used to teach at a school like 3 years ago. And you could hear, like, I remember hearing one of the parents saying, thank goodness I have the white teacher, not the black teacher. And the funny thing is that her teacher was actually a non-native speaker from Europe, who he could speak good English, but he had a, you know, very thick accent. He didn't have like a native American accent that Chinese people associate with good quality English when they're having their kids learn English. I applied for one job where they do recruiting, and they told me, sometimes we get schools who only want white people. They said, are you comfortable with that? I said yes at the time, honestly, but I wasn't comfortable, but I just didn't want to make it awkward. Now they have something called Obama Black, which is, it's basically as long as you're the color of Obama, they'll consider that okay. If you're darker than Obama, it's not okay, because at least at this point, because Obama's the president of the United States, people will, they can accept people that color as being American, but not if you're darker than that, then you're African. So it's, the perception changed a little bit with Obama, but it didn't make things like go away, basically. But you will see ads that say white only. And I saw one ad that I joke with my friend about that was like, do you have white skin? You can come work at, it was basically a job where you didn't have to do anything. You just like sat at the reception and you just say hi to people, and you'd get 16,000 RMB a month to do that as long as you're white.
So how do you process these experiences compared to racism or prejudices in your home country, for example? Like, is it any different?
Oh yeah, it's much different. Actually, a lot of black people you'll talk to say they prefer the racism in China over back in the States. And that's just because some people perceive the racism here or the prejudice here. I don't really like to call it racism, but I don't want to get into that. They perceive it to be differently because here they see it more as ignorance. Whereas in the States, it's more like hate. Like, people actually hate you and like want to kill you or threaten you violently. But in China, it's more like, it's just different. It doesn't seem like they hate you. Like, if, especially when I speak Chinese, I can go almost anywhere and talk to people, at least in the places I've been so far. And people will kind of accept me, I guess. I don't know how else to explain that, but they won't be like, oh, get out of my store. They won't follow me around in the store and see if I'm trying to steal something. They won't, like, I don't know, be rude to me. Now, that's not the case for all black people. Again, I'm the Obama black, I guess, that Chinese people are more comfortable with. So when you have kind of darker skinned black people, their experiences are much, much different than mine.
How have your experiences affected the way you perceive Chinese people?
Even despite the negative, most of them have been mostly positive, and especially knowing the culture, knowing the language, it kind of showed to me, if you kind of accept their culture and their language and kind of, not necessarily integrate, but like accept it and see them as people, they will kind of show you the same respect. Chinese people I've talked to have been very receptive. They're very likely to engage in dialogue and to talk about it, and they'll usually say, oh, I never thought of that, and you know, you really changed the way I see things. So open dialogue, changing stereotypes in TVs and movies. In particular, I'm going to keep saying that only because every time Chinese people talk to me about Americans or whatever people, they'll say, oh, I saw it on TV, or I saw it on this show. So all of that. And I think maybe if, you know, just more black, there's a lot of Africans now in China who are here to study, and they know Chinese. So also the more they interact with black people who speak Chinese, I think that will also help as well.
Did people's answer surprise you? What are your thoughts on this issue, and how would anyone doing blackface be perceived in your country? Let us know in the comments, and make sure to subscribe to Asian Boss for more local news and cultural trends from all over Asia. Thanks for watching and see you next time.